Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Super Smash Bros. For Wii U All-Star Mode. Last time we took it on as Zelda, and this time we're gonna be taking it on as Sheik. Now, as for the alts, I feel like I probably went with this dark one or this one on 3DS. So I'm gonna go ahead and go with this one, because it looks barely any different from regular Sheik, and I wanna know what the actual difference is. Let's go. Now, Sheik's gonna be an interesting one for All-Star Mode. Yeah, this doesn't look any different to regular Sheik. I am so confused. Is it just a slightly darker purple? Or, like, is it just a slightly darker blue, not a purple? I don't know why I said purple. Is that all this is? I don't understand the difference. I need to see them side by side, but we're gonna stick with it. We're not gonna switch now. We're gonna keep using this same thing. This same alt. Now, Sheik is gonna be an interesting one for All-Star, because I actually already started recording this episode, but I had to stop because of personal reasons. I was interrupted. So I decided to just restart, and I had a horrible time the first time through. I only got one fight in, but that one fight took like 2 minutes, because Sheik just has no kill moves. Now, the reason we're doing okay this time around is because we're on a walk-off stage, so it's considerably easier for us to actually get KOs with Sheik, because we can just kind of smash attack or even just forward aerial near the edge, and we should be good. Please put me down. Also, I took 40% damage on the first fight on the previous attempt, so yes, 15 is a lot better than that. I will say that much. 15 is a hell of a lot better than that. So, yeah, as long as we get more walk-off stages, I don't know why my voice went weird. As long as we get more walk-off stages than not walk-off stages, we should be fine. In theory. Ready? This is not a walk-off stage. Alrighty. Well, in that case, let me just try to rack up the damage and smash attack. It was getting to the point where I was at like 100 and, or the opponents were at like 170 damage, and my smashes weren't killing in the previous run, so I really hope he doesn't get to that point again. I just need to catch him near the edge like Lucario right there. I mean, I didn't kill him, but here we go. That's Lucas and Ike gone. Lucario's also gone. Alright, this isn't going anywhere near as horribly as I was expecting. Anyways, I should probably address the elephant in the room. Where the hell have I been? Sheik is the first video coming out for like 2 weeks, or in 2 weeks, I should say. It's been a while since we did the Zelda video. If you didn't catch the update video that I put out, one, I recommend just watching that because I explained everything better there. Because, you know, that was me in the update video at the time talking about why I'm taking a quick break. I took 2 weeks off, I needed a break, I was kind of getting a little bit overly stressed out and overworking myself, I was working a lot of overtime at my real job, so, you know, I just needed some time away, and it's certainly helped me. I feel a lot more stress-free. I had a lot more time to spend with my girlfriend, and, you know, I wasn't stressing about having to record every night upon getting home from work. I'm dead! Don't dance, villager. Don't dance. Alright, note to self, Sheik's down air kills you if you go off the stage with it. Also, I decided to change the alt that we're using because it didn't look any different. Like, let's be honest, it looked just like the regular one. I even went back and checked a little bit. And, you know, like, flip between them a couple more times. It just looks the exact same. I don't really understand what the difference is. Maybe a slightly different tone or shade of blue. But I don't know, I didn't really notice. So, we're going with this golden one this time around. Also, I found some decent ways of killing with Sheik, which I'm honestly surprised about. Like, you may have seen it right there. I managed to hit Villager off to the side and then combo it into the down B, so I should probably try that again. Also, there is actual Sheik. Let's try and dispatch her relatively quickly. Kind of like that. I mean, that's not going to kill, but yeah, she had her jump and, of course, her up B left. Alright, Cloud, you scare me. Put the limit away. Ganondorf, I'm kind of skinny and you're a big lad. I don't really want to get launched. If that is okay, there we go. That is what I'm talking about. Jigglypuff, I can probably finish you off. Right there. I turned around. Didn't mean to do that. I was going to say right here, but then I turned around. Not what I wanted. Jigglypuff, one up smash. No, that's not going to finish her off. When do I ever call Jigglypuff her? Finish it off. Jigglypuff is an it, because no one really knows its gender. It doesn't have anything determining its differing gender as a Pokemon. Like, Pikachu has the heart-shaped tail if it's female. So there were no female Pikachu until Smash Ultimate. All of them were male. Jigglypuff, I don't believe, has a distinction, so there's no way to tell. So I just say it, because it's much easier, and... Ugh. Didn't finish off Diddy, but... Is this gonna finish off Ness? Oh, that actually did finish off Ness. I was kidding, I didn't think that would do that. That's not what I meant to do just yet. Oh, I almost down aired. I panicked and I almost hit the down air button off stage. Don't do that. We learned from our mistake before. That killed him? Okay. I'm not complaining about that one. Not complaining about that one in the slightest. Alrighty, Woolly World. Very nice. Give me that Excite Bike Racer. Let's go into the next fight. Yeah, so I was explaining why I needed that break, and I think I covered most of the points. I recommend just going and watching the update video. It's called Break Time, and it should be the last video that came out before this one. Yeah, it was beneficial. I worked some overtime. I got paid. I also just fell through the stage. I don't know how that happened. I worked the overtime. I didn't have to worry about working on videos every night, so it was nice. It was real nice. There we go. And I appreciate you guys and your understanding for why I needed that break. But I'm back now, and I'm hoping for at least a few months we should have consistent uploads. I'm hoping until the end of Smash Wii U I have consistent uploads. That is the plan. I mean, plans could obviously change. I almost down-aired off the stage again, and that would have been terrifying. Yeah, that's the plan. That is what I hope happens. I hope we don't really have to take any more breaks before we finished this series. There we go. Couldn't get any freaking hits on anybody for a little while there. Sonic. Yeah, there we go. He's not quite finished. Nope. No. Oh, no. Okay, he almost gimped me with his spring right there. That was scary. I'm not gonna go off stage for him now. I'm gonna just stand here and... you know what? Nah, it doesn't really count as off stage. Whatever, we did it. We did it. Alrighty, moving right along. 3 stages remaining. This is going a lot better than I was expecting. As previously mentioned, we got 3 stages, 3 healing items. I'm gonna go ahead and use one, because 75 is a scary damage to be going into a fight with Sheik with, in my personal opinion. Now, for a time... Ooh, this is kind of a walk-off. For a time, at the beginning of Smash 4's life, Sheik was one of my mains, or one of my go-tos. Less so as it came to an end, because I just don't really enjoy playing as Sheik anymore. When I first started playing Smash 4, I was really into, like, the fast characters who don't really have the best damage output. But, you know, they do a lot of consecutive hits and you can kind of just kill opponents that way. Like Sheik, like you can carry people off stage with forward aerial and then use the down B to kill them. I really liked that. So I played a lot of characters like that when the game first launched. For example, it was Sheik, Zero Suit Samus, and I think Greninja were my first 3 mains, not including Mario, because Mario's always my main. Or pretty much always my main, I should say. So, I don't know, I feel like maybe that's why I'm not doing terrible with Sheik, because I have this prior knowledge. But at the same time, I don't really know. I think Sheik is definitely better in Smash 4 than she is in Ultimate. Like, they fixed Sheik a little bit with a patch that came out. Like, they actually put her back in the game and made her a decent character. Or made her playable. Because nobody played Sheik when Smash Ultimate first came out. Because Sheik wasn't very good. And like I mentioned, I still don't think she's the best thing in the world, so, feels kinda nice going back to Smash 4 Sheik, who was very good. Yeah! Well, very good in the right hands. Not necessarily in my hands. Alright, stage 5 has been cleared. I also need to apologize if you can hear... this is gonna sound weird, my garage. My office is right above the garage door, or above the garage, so of course right above the garage door. And my dad just came home with a new car, and he's trying to sync up the garage door remote with his car button that he has. And so he's constantly opening and closing the door. I happened to be recording as he got home, so I think, yeah, that's still happening. I don't know what's taken so long, but whatever. I apologize if you can hear the garage door opening. You probably can't. Oh no! I'm just saying that as a precaution. I'm gonna get back to the main part of the stage now, if that's okay. There we go. Yeah, I'm just saying that as a precaution because I'm recording in a different way to what I normally do. I have my mic not on my desk, it's on a mic stand which is touching the floor. So maybe the sound is gonna travel through it, I don't know. But I hope not. Oh god, I almost down aired again. I really should just not down air at all, even if I'm on stage, because it scares the piss out of me. Okay, this bumper, my god. It honestly scares the piss out of me, because I keep thinking I'm off stage and I'm not. No, Rob. Why did you look so freaking huge for a second there? That was weird. Apparently I picked up a turnip. There we go, that's not gonna kill Rob, but it did enough damage, I think. That's a dead Peach. That's a dead Rob. Come here, Duck Hunt. Come hither. I'm going to kill you. Simple as that. I love what they did with Duck Hunt in the Banjo-Kazooie reveal, though. I think I talked about, all that stuff in the Zelda video. Because I'm fairly certain the Zelda video came out before my break time video. And before that was the Direct. So I'm fairly certain I talked about it. But, yeah, Nintendo at E3 was kind of crazy. Got a lot of cool looking stuff. And two Smash characters. Actually, technically, we got six Smash characters. Because we got the four heroes, and we got Banjo, and we got Kazooie. So they put six characters into two. You know? That's how that works, right? Maybe. Alright, I'll pick that up. And let's move. Let's go on to the next fight. Well, the final fight, actually. This is round seven. Still find it kind of... Oh, this music! I was gonna say, I still find it kind of weird that, you know, we got six people in this fight, and that's way less than any other, but we all know why it's done that way, because of the years. Also, this music just reminds me of Subspace. I know it's Mario Land music, but I first heard it in Subspace, in the Subspace Emissary, back in Brawl, so... Yeah, that's just what it reminds me of. It doesn't remind me of Mario Land in the slightest. It reminds me of, I think it's The Ruins that uses this music? I could be wrong on that, but... Or is it The Ruined Zoo? It's one of those. Don't KO punch me, please. That's not a KO punch, but I don't want you to do that either. Because that could also be kind of scary. I just kind of want to kill Little Mac right now because I feel like he's going to unleash that KO punch. Okay, he's gone. We just got Pac-Man, Mario, and Mr. Gaming Watch left. Let's go. Don't hit me with a plate or whatever the hell that is. I don't really know what his down tilt is supposed to be, but it looks just like kind of like a plate. Alright, you need to stop with the perfect shield and I'm- There we go, Game Watch is gone. I just need to get another smash attack on one of these guys. I don't know why I'm panicking. I'm only at 59. I think I should be okay for right now. Yeah, that's Mario gone. Alright, man, how do you want to die? You want a grenade? That did nothing. You want a fish? How about a fish? Oh, damn it. I landed on the platform. What's the least effective way we could kill this guy right now? Like a forward... A forward tilt. You can probably kill with forward tilt, right? If I can angle this right. Oh, that could definitely kill. Bye, Pac-Man. Okay, I actually did not expect a kill with that, but I will take it. I will gladly take it. Alright, final results. We got stuff. It took 10 minutes, so it was definitely longer than a regular run, but it went a lot better than I was expecting. Alright, now it's just time for the credits game. Sheik, I feel like, won't have too tough of a time in this one. In the credits game, I should say. I don't know why I said in this one. Like, it's not like there's another one. Well, technically, this is the 3DS version. But, I don't think that's too much different. I actually don't know if- I don't remember if the images that you get for the credits game in both versions are different or not. So if anybody knows, then please let me know in the comment section. That can be our little comment question. Do you know if these pictures are any different across the 3DS and Wii U versions? It would be nice to know. I really like this one though, like it's pretty majestic. I'll give it that. Sheik is a pretty majestic character. So this makes sense. I'm fairly certain that's in the bouncing fish animation. Oh, I am bouncing all over the place. Let's do that again. Yeah! Oh, we can do that three times. I actually didn't know you could do that three times. That's pretty neat. DLC character voices got absolutely nothing for us apparently. But, yeah, we should be good. can just jab combo for most of this. And neutral aerial works really good too. So I think I'm gonna use that too. Let me drop this. That did not explode. It should any second now though. I don't know. Yep, there it goes. I don't know how much use that's gonna be, but apparently not much. Apparently not much. And this is completely unrelated to anything about this video, but besides the fact of the release date, I'm fairly certain I'm releasing this video on the 28th of June 2019. I think that's the day that they're re-releasing Avengers Endgame in movie theaters with extra footage. So, hey, you should go watch that again, even if you've already seen it, because they're doing that to try and get it to beat Avatar at the box office, and it is so close, and then Avengers Endgame will officially be the highest grossing movie of all time. And I kind of want that to happen, because I didn't really enjoy Avatar as much as I enjoyed Endgame, so if y'all could help out with that, that'd be fantastic. Also, we got kind of close to not doing this. The needles didn't hit, damn it! Whatever, we got 100%. I wanted to be all stylish and take down the very last credit using my needles, but the game said no, so I guess we don't get to do that today. Alright, let's go ahead and head into the vault, into trophies, into the gallery, and take a look at the Sheik trophies. Starting off with the alt, I did not choose the right one, but whatever. Sheik's burst grenade side special throws a small grenade that draws in nearby fighters before exploding. Once the button has been released, or after a time, it'll hop and explode. The down special bouncing fish is an attack where Sheik strikes with both heels, falling similarly to the way a fish might flop around. Appears in The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time for the N64, and The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time 3D for the Nintendo 3DS, because seriously, has Sheik been in any other game except Hyrule Warriors? And then the final Smash trophy, Light Arrow Sheik. Sheik's final smash uses a gigantic bow to fire a light arrow across the screen. If multiple foes are in its path, it will strike them all, ignoring shields like they're not even there. Sheik's light arrow is more damaging than Zelda's, and it launches its victims at a lower angle. That's interesting, I actually didn't know that that difference was a thing. And that appears in Final Smashes 2. I also think it'd be kind of interesting if Sheik's final smash actually behaved like it does in the trophy right there. I just pointed at the screen, you can't see that. Because, you know, like if you could jump up and then angle where you wanted to shoot it, I think that'd be kind of neat, but that's not a thing. But they also changed the final smash in the next game, so it's whatever. Anyways, with that folks, that is gonna go ahead and do it for this episode of Super Smash Bros. For Wii U All-Star Mode. Next time, we are gonna be continuing on with the Zelda characters and taking it on as Ganondorf. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like, and of course, let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.